SpaceX plans to recover the Falcon 9 rocket's upper stage using party balloons, this and more, now on kNews. Hey guys, Lucas here, welcome to kNews, and as always a big shout out to you my kNews boosters on Patreon. Thanks for your trust. I'm currently changing up my video format, so what you see is still work in progress. Before I swivel to the main topic of this video, let me quickly mention some recent rocket launches. For the USA, we have Orbital ATK's Antares, which launched on May 20th, and SpaceX Falcon 9 on May the 22nd. Up top Antares was a Cygnus spacecraft loaded with cargo for the International Space Station and a lot of CubeSats which will be released from the station. Falcon 9, on the other hand, carried another set of Iridium Next satellites and a secondary payload called GRACE, or Gravity Recovery and Climate Experiment. It was the second of its kind and shares a ride with Iridium because the original launch contract using a Russian rocket was cancelled. GRACE's main mission is to continue updating the map of the Earth's gravity field. The changes happening to the gravity field surrounding us is used to figure out what exactly is going on inside our planet. And lastly, there was surprisingly only one rocket for China, which was a Long March 4C on May 20th as well, pushing three satellites. The main one is a relay satellite for the Chinese rover that will explore the far side of the moon, named Chang'e 4. In order to control and communicate with a rover that has no direct line of sight to Earth, such a relay is needed. It will be placed near the so-called Lagrange point 2 behind the moon. Just by the way, I recently learned that the guy who this point is named after was actually Italian, so maybe a more correct pronunciation would be Lagrangia. Anyhow, important to know is this particular region in space is where the Earth and the Moon's gravity add up in just the right way so that a satellite placed there orbits Earth at the same rate the Moon does, despite it being on a higher, thus normally slower orbit. Now, the satellite will not hover in a stationary point relative to the Moon because it would be blocked by it and instead orbit around the Lagrange point itself, so it will appear like a halo for those watching from the Moon. Halo orbits around Lagrange points are some of the strangest gravitational phenomena, and I actually wanted to make a video about them a long time ago, but as it turns out, they are way more complicated to explain than it seems. I actually think there is no really intuitive explanation for why one can orbit that point, other than that's just how the math works out, but I'll keep thinking about it. And now to the main topic of the video, which is of course Falcon's not yet but hopefully soon reusable upper stage. As every space enthusiast is aware of, SpaceX is recovering and reusing their first stage boosters. The first stage turns around in space and guides itself like a missile after separation, using grid fins to hit its target drone ship out in the ocean. Then, just before impact, up to three engines ignite to land on the floating platform, which is stabilized and held in place by the ship's extremely powerful and foldable propellers. This still one-of-a-kind maneuver is what makes SpaceX so different from other rocket companies, which all throw away their boosters, crashing them into the ocean. Having figured out how to land the booster safely, SpaceX also decided to recover their multi-million dollar payload fairing. While it looks simple, this fairing pushes against all the aerodynamic pressure during launch to protect the payload up top. It's normally separated once the rocket leaves the atmosphere to then also crash into the ocean. A rather simple solution SpaceX came up with is to equip each of the fairing halves with a parafoil and cold gas thrusters. The thrust keeps them oriented and stable while they re-enter back into the atmosphere before the parafoil is released. Operating a parafoil above such a giant piece of hardware is extremely challenging due to all the turbulences, and SpaceX is not yet able to land their fairings routinely, but they're of course working on it. Each half is supposed to land on a second ship out in the ocean called Mr. Steven. It has a giant net stretched over four enormous pillars, and I assume they will have two of these in the future. That's what Elon Musk refers to as a bouncy castle, by the way. It's bouncy, but castle? Not so much. But let's not start to nitpick, because there will probably be no party balloons recovering the upper stage either. So the last part of the rocket that remains crashing into the ocean is that upper stage. Recovering and reusing it has not the highest priority for SpaceX, since they are working on their next gen rocket, the BFR, which stands for...
It's the big Falcon rocket.
However, they are going to try it, improving it progressively. Similar to the fairings, the upper stage is supposed to land on a ship, probably also using a parafoil of some sort, only bigger. The most difficult part, though, is to re-enter back into the atmosphere without breaking up, which is a completely different endeavor, flying at orbital speeds. One important thing to keep in mind is every kilogram added to the upper stage means a kilogram less payload, since the upper stage goes where the payload goes naturally. So I assume this is only an option for either light Falcon 9 payloads or the Falcon Heavy. The most popular method on the internet to get the upper stage back is a so-called balut. No, not that balut, guys, from the Philippines. This one is a fusion between a balloon and a parachute. Ha! It inflates itself like a parachute without the need of any gas, while providing a huge surface area to act as a giant drag brake, essentially. The idea is to decrease the speed as fast as possible during re-entry and keep the nose of the stage pointing downwards. Without it, the heaviest part would face the hot plasma, which would of course be the engine section. It could then double to either land the upper stage safely on a ship, or maybe even allow to catch it with a giant drone like the United Launch Alliance plans to do with their Vulcan rocket's engine section. However, latter sounds a little too complex for SpaceX, since this recovery is not a priority right now. But who knows? I'm not quite sure how all of that would work out, especially since the balut had to be heat resistant. But that's just one way they could do it, and I want to explore a more crazy method. While the balut idea sounds really good and was even tried before, I'm still a little bit skeptical about this approach. The reason is, it can only be used during re-entry and they couldn't deorbit or lose speed before that happens. Such a balut also had to be mounted next to the engine, which could have unknown consequences to a launch, and I doubt they will do a test launch with it or recertify the upper stage. Mounting inflatable stuff as a secondary payload inside the fairing, on the other hand, should be no big deal. So I think they will at least start putting stuff there to gain experience before they make changes in more dangerous areas. So what could they do in order to re-enter without destroying the expensive engine? The solution is to get rid of as much speed as possible while still in space. It's of course highly speculative at this point, but the upper stage tanks are pressurized with helium gas as they drain. Once the mission is over, this gas is vented into space to make sure the upper stage tanks do not rupture from heating up in the sunlight. As you can imagine, this gas could also be used to inflate a giant balloon. To make things a little less complicated and stable, SpaceX could also omit the rope and mount the balloon or multiple balloons directly to the payload adapter. However, doing it like this, they had to mount a pipe at the side of the vehicle, since all the necessary connections are at the bottom where the engine is. I'm not sure if SpaceX is willing to do changes to its fuel piping system to reuse the upper stage, but for this video, I assume they do. If not, it's probably going to be a self-inflating balut, as mentioned in the beginning, that does not require internal gas. A benefit of such side-mounted balloons would be they could act like giant inflatable fins, basically. Varying the pressure and size, they could even steer the upper stage and point the bottom section in the right direction to bounce off the atmosphere, a little like the space shuttle used to do, in order to lose as much velocity as possible before they hit the thicker, more dense layers where the real heating begins. Whatever they come up with and which orientation the upper stage will re-enter, they will not be able to get rid of all the velocity, so some kind of heat shield will be needed. SpaceX plan is to add more and more insulation to its upper stage, similar to what they've done to their new Block 5 booster. They covered all the parts that are exposed to re-entry heat with their black insulating material. They will either shield more of the engine or come up with a payload adapter shielding solution where they can still mount the payload safely. Though, I personally only see it as a backup plan should the development of BFR not go as smoothly and take much longer than expected. Having a completely reusable rocket would make a big difference and would drop the cost to launch Falcon down to single-digit million values, competing even with the smallest of launchers, even if it was a Falcon Heavy. Do you have some thoughts on it as well? Feel free to leave a comment below the video. I read all of them. Okay. That shall conclude this episode. I hope to see you next one if you like, and become a patron. Auf Wiedersehen and thank you for watching.
It's the big Falcon rocket.